Workers constructed more than 1,000 calutrons at Y-12 to separate uranium-235 from uranium-238. Bill Wilcox, who worked at Y-12 during the Manhattan Project, describes how the calutrons worked.
These were complex physics machines. And at Y-12, they ended up with 1,152 of them. 864 were great big ones, about 8 feet tall, and the rest of them were 350 or so, were smaller machines. One of them we call alpha calutrons, one of them we call beta calutrons. The way the separation takes place is that you have an electromagnet, a strong electromagnet, and it's big, it's about 8 feet tall. And then in between these magnets, you put a vacuum tank, pump it out, and you vaporize some uranium tetrachloride, heat it up to about 400 degrees, and it boils out of this tank down here at the bottom. And then you bang it with an electron stream and give it a positive charge. And you can accelerate that so that the stream comes zipping out. Well, if you didn't have a magnet, that stream would just go in a straight line until it stopped. But with a magnet, it bends that stream in a hemispherical semicircle. So these charged molecules go zipping around in a long circle. And up at the top, you see the heavier ones have taken a larger diameter course than the lighter ones. So that up at the top, you have a little separation, maybe a quarter of an inch between the 235 stream and the 238 stream. And so then you put a pocket up here with slits in it, and the 238s go in one slit, the 235s in another. And it's a batch process. You put so much uranium tetrachloride in here, and you run it for 3 or 4 days, and then you take it apart, and you have to clean everything up and start all over again.
The calutrons required an exorbitant amount of energy and 22,000 employees. A year after the war ended, all of the Y-12 calutrons were shut down except for those in Beta 3. These operated until 1998, producing isotopes for medical and other purposes.